This morning on The Dish, acclaimed chef Michael Voltaggio. Born in Maryland, at 15, he got his first job thanks to his brother, a sous chef at a local hotel restaurant. After an apprenticeship at the prestigious Greenbrier Resort and jobs with renowned chefs like Charlie Palmer and Jose Andres, he broke out on his own.
In 2011, he opened LA's Inc., now Inc. Well, named GQ's best new restaurant in America. And 2 years later, Voltaggio was named one of Food & Wine's best new chefs. His latest ventures include Starfish in Santa Monica and the upcoming Monger in Miami. Chef Michael Voltaggio, welcome to The Dish.
Welcome,
good morning.
Chef.
That intro is fantastic.
You're welcome.
Well, this table is fantastic. And tell us what's here.
This is like if you've had a proper night out, maybe a couple whiskeys in this case, some Dewars.
Yes.
How do you transition into brunch, you know? And so starting over here, this is fresh grits. It's basically corn that's been grated on a box grater, and then you cook it until it's thick like scrambled eggs.
Mm.
Oh boy,
here, it just looks like fried chicken, but it's actually breaded in cornflakes.
Yum.
So the cornflake chicken goes with the corn. Here's like a little vegan little gem salad with a goddess dressing made with avocado. And then this is the Maryland boy in me. These are waffles that I've actually baked crab meat into. So it's like a waffle crab cake baked together.
Why not?
And then last but not least, this is a coffee cake that's drizzled with a little bit of Dewar's caramel on top of it. So,
because we all
little
need
hair
that.
Of the dog, if you will.
Yeah, and speaking of hair of the dog, this is coffee?
The thing I like about this is it's orgeat, which is like almond liqueur, and then you've got coffee, you've got some Dewar's 12, and you put it in the jar and you put the lid on and you shake it, so your latte, you can actually shake it here. This is your cocktail shaker.
I love it. And so, scotch.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Cheers with our coffee.
Wow.
So, chef, age 15, you're already working in a restaurant. Tell us about that.
You know, my brother was coming home with stuff. And you know, I was super envious of that. I'm like, how are you buying things? And he's like, I have a job. And I'm like, I want a job because I want stuff.
Right.
And be careful what you ask for, because I ended up going to work for my brother.
Uh-huh. But you liked it, and you like your brother. You're still in business with him.
We are. I love my brother very much. He's a mentor and definitely like an inspiration for me. Yeah, for sure. It's
so
hard to please him.
Where did the food thing ignite there then?
My father was a police officer, and he worked in a hotel, like security at night. And so
right.
He actually got Brian and I jobs at this hotel.
Yeah.
And so, like I said, it was just a matter of going to work. But then we both found ourselves liking that part of our day the most. So I was in high school. I would go to school. I would go to football practice, and then I would go to work. And I worked full time. So I was working like 4 hours a week while I was in high school.
Wow. It wasn't all just hotel restaurants. You were at the Greenbrier, which is a very serious culinary destination. Tell us about that.
I went into that program at 19. My mentor there, Peter Timmons, who's actually passed away since, he was just this encyclopedia of knowledge, and the guy could recite like Escoffier, like he was reading it off the back of his hand.
Wow.
And so I just wanted that education. I wanted a proper formal training.
What took you ultimately to Los Angeles?
Jose Andres. I had a phone call.
The great Jose.
It was Mr. Botayo, because that's how he said my last name. And he's like, I'm opening a restaurant in Los Angeles. And so I went and cooked lunch for Jose in D.C.
Yeah.
And I thought I was getting to open up like the 40-seat restaurant, but it was a 200-plus seat restaurant.
Wow.
And Jose said to me, it's the same job. I'll just build a bigger kitchen and give you more cooks. And I'm like, makes complete sense. And so I packed my bags and I went to Los Angeles.
What did he teach you about technique?
Jose, you know what's funny is everyone associates Jose with like modern cooking, but Jose is very much traditional. You know,
yeah.
He's focused on Spanish cuisine and his passion and his heart, but his ability to like take food that should be served for 12 people a night because of the amount of technique that goes into it and being able to provide it for like 200 people in an affordable way too. I think he brings like 3-star Michelin food to people at a lower price point so more people can experience it.
A lot of people go on Top Chef to establish their careers. You were already established. What made you take that leap?
I wanted to bridge that gap between chefs and chefs that play chefs on TV. I felt like, and I know that sounds funny, but like I wanted to create more opportunity for myself. And I know it was a risk because eventually you're gonna be labeled like, oh, you're that guy from Top Chef.
Right.
And you know, to be honest, I didn't care about like the comments and stuff like that because I think it provided opportunity for more serious chefs mm-hmm. to go and do more television. And therefore, getting outside of your kitchen a bit more and ultimately bringing more people into your restaurants.
You have a restaurant opening up in a couple months with your brother, Brian, in Miami. And you like Miami as a food city.
I think Miami is one of the most exciting food cities in the country right now. I think there's a lot of young chefs down there. You've got Brad Kilgore with Alder, who's killing it. You've got, you know, a lot of the serious big name chefs are going down there too and opening restaurants. And I think when you see that, you know that it's going to become serious, but I think the reason that it happens is because there's already this young community thriving there of talent. And for me, Miami is like what LA was when LA just became this amazing food city.
Over All right, bi-coastal, Miami, LA, not New York, LA, changing the mix.
Yeah, New York, you can't drop a restaurant off in New York. You have to be here.
That is definitely true. Chef, as I ask you to sign this dish, custom on the program, if you could share this bounty with any figure, past or present, who would it be?
I would say my mom, because she always put dinner on the table at 5:30 every single night, and that was like, That memory of food for me was the most important one of my life. It's sometimes not just about the food, but just gathering people around the table. And my mom did that, so yeah, for sure.
Right on. And she has two great sons who have done her cooking proud. Chef Michael Voltaggio, thank you. And for more on Chef Voltaggio and the dish, head to our website at cbsthismorning.com.